In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon his last and beloved Messenger Muhammad, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. This is part 6 of a series entitled Discoveries from the Quran. And in this series, brothers and sisters, I show the superiority of the knowledge of Allah, God Almighty, in the Quran, in the last revelation to people, over the knowledge of people in this day and age, and how by pondering upon the verse of the Quran, the believer can be the teacher of others. So the topic for this presentation is, the one you can see on the screen, the cure for forgetfulness and weakened concentration. Now, this is a big problem that people face nowadays, that forgetting important matters in their life, in everyday life. Also, the difficulty in concentrating on their work, on their study, all aspects. And another very famous, what people call as a mental illness, and as you'll see in this presentation, is not a mental illness, something called ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder. And this is the most famous with a mental condition associated with forgetfulness and weakened concentration. And some of the symptoms of this ADHD, forgetting important matters in everyday life, fast switching and random switching between different activities, unable to concentrate on a certain activity, being bored of doing anything very, very fast, and always kind of in a state of confusion. That's some of the symptoms. So in modern kind of psychology and modern psychology, there is no known cure for this, and there is no definite diagnosis for this. So we have a big problem here. They don't know the cause for this. I don't know how to cure it. That is a fact in modern psychology. So if we go to the Quran, in the Quran, Allah teaches us the correct diagnosis, knowing the cause for this, and the how to cure it. So the first verse to ponder upon is verse number 63 of chapter 18 of the Quran, which reads, He said, Do you remember when we betook ourselves to the rock? I indeed forgot the fish. None but Satan made me forget to remember it. It took its course into the sea in a strange way. So, of course, this is a story of mentioning the Quran about a journey that Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, took. And on this journey, his companion, they had a fish, and he forgot the fish, his companion. And when he was asked about this, his answer was, none but Satan made me forget to remember it. That's part of his answer. So Allah is telling us here in a clear, straightforward way that the only cause for forgetfulness, of you forgetting important matters in your life, is Satan. That's the only cause for forgetting matters. Another verse to ponder upon is verse number 71 of chapter 6 of the Quran, which reads, Say, shall we invoke others besides Allah God that can do us neither good nor harm? And shall we turn back on our heels after Allah God has guided us? Like one whom the devils have made to go astray in the land in confusion, his companions calling him to guidance, come to us, say, Verily, Allah's guidance is the only guidance, and we have been commanded to submit to the Lord of all that exists. So here again, Allah is telling us that the reason why a person is in confusion, is always confused, is Satan, the devils. Like one whom the devils have made to go astray in the land in confusion. So, if we compare, brothers and sisters, the symptoms of the most famous mental condition associated with forgetfulness and weakened concentration with the symptoms of the effect of Satan on people regarding this matter, we see a perfect match. So Allah is telling us in the Quran that Satan makes you forget important aspects in your life, and one of the symptoms of ADHD, forgetting matters. Also, Allah is telling us that Satan makes you confused, and another symptom of ADHD is confusion. Now, to understand more and more how Satan can cause you to forget matters and being confused, we need to understand the scientific mechanism on how Satan affects each and every one of us. And as that as well is mentioned in the Quran. The Quran contains knowledge of everything. So the physical mechanism and the scientific mechanism on how Satan affect each and every one of us, and no one is immune from this, is explained in the Quran in chapter 114, verse 4, which reads, "From the evil of the whisperer who hides, from the evil of the whisperer who hides." So Allah is telling us here that there is evil, there is harm from the whisperer. Whisperer is Satan. So Allah is telling us that Satan, he whispers to each and every one of us. He talks to us. But at the same time, he hides from us. So he whispers and he hides, meaning that he doesn't want you to feel his presence. He hides from you. So the only way that Satan, your companion devil, and each and every one of us has a companion devil, as I said, no one is immune from this. The way he hides from you is that he matches his voice to the one you hear in your head. If each and every one of us, when we think quietly, we hear the same voice we speak with in our mind. So what Satan does, he matches his voice with regards to tone, frequency, the languages you know, your style of speech, to the voice you hear in your head. And thoughts, they pop up in your mind. And you think that yourself is talking to you because this voice is identical, well, actually it's Satan. So I hope now it's clear the scientific mechanism of how Satan affects each and every one of us, how he gets into our head. He matches his voice, once again, to the voice you think with. So ideas pop up in your mind, and you think that yourself is telling you this, that you are thinking to yourself with this, but actually it's Satan. So, now, let's see, after understanding this mechanism, how Satan makes us forget matters and being confused. Let me give you by examples. Suppose that you leave your house in the morning, and you are in your car on the way to work, and you have a very important appointment or something to do on the way. How can Satan make you forget this appointment? The way he does it is that, as I said, he matches his voice to the one you think in your mind. He comes to you, for example, telling you, you forgot to lock the door, the front door of your house. You'll be robbed. This and that will happen to you. And all of this you hear in your mind, thoughts that pop up in your mind with a voice match the one you think with. He starts telling you, for example, about a certain conversation at work or happened yesterday. And you start responding in your mind like a conversation, a whole conversation in your mind. You are talking and somebody's answering you in your mind. He takes the role of a colleague of yours in your work. So having confused you with all of these thoughts, you're just preoccupied with these thoughts, you are occupied with these thoughts, you forget important matters in your life. I hope now it's clear how it makes you forgetful. He puts so many ideas in your mind. You start talking and like daydreaming and all of this, you forget important matters in your life. Now, how can he make you confused? The same mechanism. If you want to think about something, he starts putting ideas in your mind. But if this and that, maybe this, maybe that, starting arguing with you in your mind, when you want to think about something, but this, but that, so it makes you confused. Another example, you want to sit down and read something. You start reading the first line in the page. Suppose that you want to study a page in a book, and that page takes you 10 minutes to study. The start reading the first line, he starts with a voice matter when you think with in your mind, reminding you of something happened yesterday, something you will do tomorrow. And again, daydreaming, like putting ideas in your mind, if I was famous, what will happen, how people will talk to me. And you see somebody's talking to you on the other side, like he's mimicking somebody else. So you want to finish this page, 4 hours have passed, and you not finish the first line. So see weakened concentration. And all of this is achieved, as Allah states in the Quran, from the evil of the whisperer who hides. Look at the beauty and precision and knowledge contained in the Quran. So having understood this, that Satan is the only reason we forget important matters of our life and we have weakened concentration. What's the cure? The cure again is mentioned in the Quran. In chapter 7, verse 201, this is the cure for all of this. The verse reads the following. Verily, those who are pious, when a thought comes to them from Satan, they remember and they then see. Again, verily, those who are pious, when a thought comes to them from Satan, they remember and they then see. So, how we can be cured from the effect of Satan as causing us forgetfulness and weakened concentration? Allah is telling us here that when a thought comes to you from Satan, you remember and then you will see. Meaning that suppose that you're reading a book, these ideas start popping up in your mind. You remember. What do I mean by this? You remember. That you remember this guidance you are hearing now, that the source of these thoughts reminding me of something I did yesterday and something I do today is from my companion devil, from Satan. It's not from my own self. And this companion devil of mine, he wants to waste my life. He wants to waste the potential that Allah placed in my mind and my brain. So what I need to do, I need to ignore these thoughts, stop thinking about them, and concentrate on what I'm doing. I hope now the answer is clear. And you can see from the beauty of the Quran, they remember and then they see, they remember. So again, if you experience these thoughts, and each and every one of us experience these thoughts, you start realizing that the source of these thoughts that causes me mental pain, agitation, weakened concentration, forgetfulness, is from my companion devil, from my enemy. And not my own self is thinking like this. So I know I need to ignore these thoughts, stop thinking about them, not going into a cycle of thinking and daydreaming about them. Day after day, you start concentrating in your life more and more. That is the cure. There is no secret pill that you can take, and and these thoughts will stop. You need to strive and struggle by ignoring these thoughts, not allowing them to affect your life. Day after day, you will concentrate more and more. But the key thing is to understand this guidance, is that you are not alone in your mind. There is an enemy who matches his voice to yours, who camouflages himself, and gets into your mind by popping ideas in your mind, by a thought matching the one you think with, by a voice matching the one you think with. And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com. This is the website, and you can email me at zquran@yahoo.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.